Seamless and Grubhub are awesome. I mean, it's pretty cool that you can get cookies delivered to you at 1 a.m. in the morning. But sometimes don't you wish you could just, like, magic the food to you? Because it's kind of annoying having to go online and, like, click all the buttons and, like, say whether you want cutlery or not. Don't you wish you could just say, grilled catfish, and it would appear? Or as Captain Jean-Luc Picard would say, we would like tea, Earl Gray. Hot. In the Star Trek universe, they have already answered the food delivery problem with replicators. Super cool gadgets that can spit out basically every inanimate object that you could wish for, just by asking for it. It works by taking atoms found throughout the universe and just reassembling them. Easy, right? What I really want for Christmas is one of these in real life. But could it ever happen? So in Star Trek, replicators can create things from food to human organs to machine parts. But could they exist in real life? Well, in today's real non-fiction world, NASA is already working on it. They invented a 3D printer, which they sent up into space, and it prints all sorts of stuff that they didn't think they'd need, but actually do now they're up there. Like a socket wrench, and even replacement parts for the printer itself. It works just by emailing a design file to the astronauts. They print it out, boom. But who cares about wrenches? I want 3D printed food. Well, this year, a new restaurant in London called Food Inc. is the world's first restaurant to have a menu made just with foods that have all been 3D printed. The bases of the foods are usually hummus, pizza dough, cheese, and chocolate, since they can solidify and provide enough structure to the food. But the real question that remains is, will we be able to get something exactly like the replicators that works as efficiently, like in the movies? Well, unfortunately, most likely not. Okay, this requires a bit of nerd out physics factor here, so bear with me. Atoms make up molecules, and when they're bonded together, they're very close to each other. Entropy, part of the law of thermodynamics, means the measure of disorder of atoms. So for example, if we had a bunch of gas molecules stuffed in a corner, entropy would be low because the atoms are very close. But if we had gas molecules spread freely inside a really large box, then entropy would be high because the atoms would be more disorganized. Taking in the fact that nature prefers high entropy over low entropy means that it could be very difficult to construct something that's very organized, like a steak. The chances of the atoms getting together to make the steak are just very low. Now, you can theoretically make matter directly out of energy, but the amount of energy you would need to create a cup of Earl Grey tea would be astronomical. Imagine that we wanted to create a cup of tea that weighs about 0.5 pound, or roughly 1/4 kilogram. Using Einstein's principle of E equals mc² shows the amount of kinetic energy would be 0.25 kilograms times the speed of light in meters per second, squared, which equals 2.25 million billion joules of energy. That amount of energy to make just one cup of tea would be enough energy to feed the entire population of Earth for 6 months, or it would be equivalent to the energy in 500 megaton nuclear bombs. So sorry, Star Trek lovers and food lovers. Physics says replicators just aren't possible. Anything from Star Trek that you'd like to see come to real life? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below, or tweet us at SciQ_TYT.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.